Hey guys, let's continue with our what to buy, what to speculate on, and this should be no surprise. The time to get these is now if you don't already have your playset. These are going to go up a lot in price, what evidence do I have? Star City Games raised their buy list with the exception of the Windswept Heath. For the most part, these cards are $15 on buy list. And that's interesting because you can buy them for under $15. So Star City Games, which has a dominant, I would say, if they want to spike a price, they have the buying power to spike a price. A lot of you get confused with individuals like Craig, and you think that he has enough buying power. He does not have nearly the buying power of Star City Games. And selling power, if Star City Games is buying these up at $15 a pop minus Windswept Heath, Windswept Heath is the one I would actually target because, yes, there's an additional copy in one of the, the dual decks or something like that. The decks that had Siege Rhino, those decks are actually very good value. Class packs, that's what they're called, class decks. I still like it because you never know when the meta is going to change colors. Flooded Strand is at 15, the low is 12. You could probably pick up copies for under 15. But the key here is Star City Games has moved the price. They have said, hey, we're willing to pay $15 for a near mint version of this card, therefore it is at least $15. That is the bottom. And eventually the price is removed. When they said, hey, Underground Sea is near mint. So again, it has to be near mint. And Underground Sea is $500 to us. Guess where the price moved the next day? Because they bought everyone out. This has happened in the past with another Fetch Land. These Zendikar Fetch Lands. Remember when they bought all these Zendikar Fetch Lands? They used to be $9 to $12. And then suddenly they were $40 and eventually they became $100. MTG Finance is not governed by individuals. An individual does not have a buying power. I mean, unless they are a millionaire or, I don't know. I don't know who all pay for magic. I don't know if there's like a millionaire stock. They have absolute magic. But you would need six figures to have a buying power. And at least when I see it, when I see articles, and I don't particularly read those, but they don't rob me as someone who's super rich, right? They're writing MTG Finance articles sometimes for a sizable percentage of their income. It's not the CEO of Zappos is buying massive cards, right? You never hear that. And even if they did, they wouldn't tell you. That's fine. So, I don't know, when I read these articles and watch the games, I think about, what is your actual day job? Is that day job $50,000 on top of that? Yes, I understand a lot of you. Woodford Hills is a good one. I love Woodford Hills. Unfortunately, I've sold so a foil place that I'm losing, which I now look like an idiot for it. So dumb. I don't know what I was doing. But anyway, I'm taking my advice now and hoarding them all. And I'm not going to trade a single fence land after this time period until $40. They have a lot of value. Oh, back to the tangent. So the tangent is, here's the scenario, and this scenario does not go well with the regular. Rich people are not going to tell you what made them rich. So if you do have an MTG Finance wizard, he's not going to tell you, hey dudes, this is how I made money. Oh, buy this card. Because if you buy the card, I'm not going to buy any more of this. I'm stopped for this and traveling to have the season in the past. I don't think I'm trading any of them because I'm stopped trading. I'm just going to go trading. Because people were like, you can change, you're going to buy me, come on, dude, this is it. It makes sense. Like, alright, back to the tangent of the tangent. Okay, this is another quick point. Let's go near it is second, or very close. Yeah, obviously I've included, but Bloodstream Mirror, given the power of Death Shadow, and the fact that we don't play a plus in that evil, obviously taxing and all this stuff. It's a lot that's saying. So it's not really that super important. Although maybe Delta has blue in it, it's black. A black that's saying. So when you talk about blood skin and mirror, that's extremely attractive because it's black and red. It's got shadow and light. So you never know. If Death Shadow gets banned and we get like a green light deck, this one's going to spike the price and this one's going to go down. So always, in my opinion, always buy the cheapest land because who knows what's going to be banned and who knows what's going to be printed. You don't know. But the land will always still be there. Alright, back to my rant about, like, I would say if someone was really good at this, they wouldn't tell you. If someone was really bad at this, they would tell you. You might think, oh, what about you? I just don't really care. I'm sure that a lot of you watch these videos because we have become a finance channel. That's just what we became. I fought it, and finally I just said, okay, I know this is what you guys want. So I'll make the videos. And I know this particular video, this type of video where I tell you to trade for this and I tell you to buy this is what you want to do. I don't care. I'm not going to buy anymore, I'm not going to sell anymore, I'm holding, because at the end of the day, so remember I was telling you, if someone is making money and giving you advice, be a little skeptical. If someone is behind a paywall, okay, that's interesting. If someone's supporting Keep a Trade, interesting, they gain points. You have to be inquisitive as to who's telling you this. For me, I just don't care. I don't care enough for, and I don't have enough invested in this card to be like, that's spiking. No, this card is going up because it starts to be good. Regardless of what I do or what I say, this card is on the rise. These five cards are on the rise. It has been proven time and time again. Star City Games, Blazers, and Bios, and a land card, like the Zen card, that's not exactly doing it. I'm reserved. It's like any land that they've ever done it for. The card has, within a month or two, increased drastically in price. That's just that. Why am I telling you this? Because this is my channel. And you're telling me that stuff. And, you know, I don't make any money for, like, how much money do I make from Magic? Like, one of the questions that I get a lot. Do I actually make money from Nintendo Finance? I make quote money. So when Valia goes from 2 to 14, I quote make $12. But I'm just going to hold on to her, and I do know a reprint is coming. And once she's reprinted, I will continue to buy more of her. You might think, oh, that's terrible finance. But that does not mean I cannot pick Valia. Valia was $2. Like, I showed it to you, so it's under $2. I have been saying buy. I mean, if there's one speculation associated with this channel, if you look at the channel's artwork and stuff, it's all Valia, right? I love her to death, but my loving her did not increase her price, right? No matter how much I told you to buy her, her price never increased until the general public was like, wait a second, this is a very unique ability, it's a legendary creature, very aggro, and you played a legacy of modern, and years. It lessened the years, but I mean, it's a good card. It is a very hard. Look at it. I've been playing Magic since beta. I say to myself, this is a pretty strong card. Why is it only $2? Whatever. Let's continue to buy it. And then eventually, it's when. $2.50, I stopped buying her at $4 or $5 because I just hadn't continued so much that it got kind of boring. But in hindsight, I shouldn't continue. It took her from Dark Ascension until, it probably took her Dark Ascension until, I want to say, Karns or Tarkir before she even had a slight price tag. And now her curve is spiking like crazy, mainly because finally people realize she's good. I've been playing her in my decks forever. Not there's another fight that I really like. That I like as much as you just want. No, I'm not certain. 100% certain that the old fighter would be a 14-15-20 opponent, assuming no rematch. This new fighter, I'm not certain, because it costs one more. If it costs one less, and you like reduce the power and toughness, and it's a 2-1, or something, yes, I would see a lot of play. It would be very good, but it doesn't do it. So anyway, that is a long rant. Bye, guys.